are joined today by Professor SKB Asante and Ambassador Ashraf Rashid. We are talking today about the Africa Peer Review Mechanism, or APRM, which is a main tool for assessing and measuring government performance in Africa. Ambassador Rashid, let's start with you. Ghana's APRM has been hailed as one of the best in the continent. What are the continental lessons that could be drawn from Ghana's experience?
Certainly, I have to say that Ghana's experience is one of the models to be emulated. It's a successful story within APRM. First of all, the availability of the political will, the leadership which assured that this process goes through. Secondly, the composition of the National Governing Council in Ghana from prominent personalities from the civil society who have a lot of integrity. Number three, engaging the civil society and the media in general in the process and going to districts and localities. And thirdly, ensuring that the whole process has credibility.
Professor Asante, this experience, which is seen as the best in the continent, can you share with us what were the main concerns, issues of governance that have since been resolved through the APRM process?
The APRM had got a lot of impact on Ghana's governance in various ways. But simply, in the area of chieftaincy, if the chieftaincy plays a major role in Ghana's system, traditional system, and so on, but then the APRM came up, and we found out, no, it's such an important aspect of Ghana's governance system, there was a need to put it in a better shape. And so as a result of it, through the APRM recommendation, the government have set up a full Ministry of Chieftaincy and Culture. In addition to that, there was also one major issue. We found out that there was a Ministry of Parliamentary Affairs, and we consider that this will actually blur the whole question of separation of powers, blur the relationship between the legislature and executive. So the APRM came, and our report, we made quite clear that this should actually be abolished, which was also abolished. We can have another more case, particularly with regard to the idea of one country having one part very well developed, not well developed, but at least developing, and on the other part, you see a lot of poverty. The APRM now report, we found out that no, there's a need for us to bridge that gap between the less developed and relatively developed parts of Ghana. So we came out with a report which was adopted.
So Prof, what would you say then was the secret of success for Ghana?
The APRM came and we felt that it was really a celebration of our long felt commitment to democracy and good governance. And so we had the support of the two political parties. And in fact, they have taken it so seriously. You see them questioning the government officers about on the issue of corruption, on the issue of health, education, and so on. So that sort of interaction is really good.
Ambassador Rashid, Ghana makes things look easy about the APRM. In your experience, why was it difficult for some countries that were undertaking this process?
There are several reasons for this, and we are trying to be supportive, not to criticize really, because these countries have opted to join voluntarily, so it's their own intention to fulfill their obligations, but we need to support them to do it. One, there is a funding problem. Some countries feel difficulty in funding the structures or the national structures of the APRM. Secondly, some lack experience or technical capability to do the self-assessing reports. And thirdly, as I mentioned before, to have a successful process, you need political will. What we are trying to do is to encourage and to support. First, we can support those countries in finances through our strategic partners, which is UNDP, ACA, and Africa Development Bank. we can also let them share the experiences from countries who have been successful in implementing the process, like Ghana and others. And we are doing workshops to enhance the capacity of countries. 30, there is the political will, and this is in the hands of the citizens of the country. And that's why we are engaging parliaments, we are engaging the civil society, and we hope that by time, all countries will fulfill their obligations.
Thank you very much, gentlemen, for joining us here today.